This video accompanies the paper Exploration of Networks Using Overview and Detail with Constraint-Based Cooperative Layout. Central to our system is the idea of topology-preserving layout. In this small example, you can clearly see that connectors are impermeable rubber band-like boundaries. Our constraint-based layout engine is complemented by a shortest path routing scheme. The routing algorithm can also trace out a suggested path, for example, as suggested by the user, or to repair an existing routing after modifications to the graph structure. As the user manipulates and edits the graph, the layout engine is running continuously in its own thread to improve and beautify the layout. We use the same rubber banding technique to obtain impermeable cluster boundaries as in this small Venn diagram example. In this example of overview and detail network navigation, we show how our constraint-based graph layout engine is used to obtain high-quality layout in the detail view, which is coordinated with a fast multipole method providing layout in the overview. In this example, we show navigation of a biological pathway with hundreds of nodes. The user can select a focal node and a neighborhood around that node to show in the detailed view either by clicking directly on the overview window or by selecting the precise focal node in the detailed view. The constraint layout engine allows us to interactively zoom into detail in nodes or subgraphs while maintaining the topology of the surrounding layout. The user is also able to override the topology by dragging whilst holding down the Alt key. We call the neighborhood in the detailed view the primary graph. The complete supergraph shown in the overview is called the secondary graph. The short red spikes attached to nodes indicate that they have connections in the secondary graph, which will be expanded when that node is made the focus. Now we'll explore a large UML collaboration network. Here we apply a styling tool to a small selection of nodes. Constraints are inferred to orthogonalize the layout of those nodes. These constraints are persistent, even when the nodes to which they apply leave the primary graph. This is quite a complicated network with many links. Occasionally, the user is able to improve the topology by manually overriding. In this final detailed example, the user has applied a number of placement tools to infer constraints for high-quality layout. The beauty of constraint-based layout is that the automatic layout supports the user, but ultimately the user has precise control over the placement of nodes and the routing of cluster boundaries and connectors.